Get ready to match the star. Nipsey Russell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Anita Gillette. Richard Dawson. And Joanne Worley. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now the star of Match Game 74, Gene Raver.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. You got a bunch of live ones again, John. Terrific. Are you alive?
They're drunk.
What did you do when you walked down those stairs?
I was just doing nonchalanting it, as Yogi Berra would say.
I think you'd probably like to do Hello, Dolly, the way you make it.
Yes, I would. That's the way she walked down the stairs, wasn't it? Well, you know, I did ballet class for a while there, and that's the way ballet dancers walk.
Along with your needlepoint, Gene.
What's that?
Along with your needlepoint.
Yes. You get the whole picture? I do needlepoint, and I used to do ballet. Yeah. Ah, wrong!
Well, in all fairness, it kept you out of the army.
That's it. Wrong! 3 years I was in cold storage.
Yes. I don't mind a guy.
Yes, I was.
Whose side?
What'd you say, Charles?
I don't mind a guy that sews or a guy that does needlepoint or does ballet.
Yeah.
But if I see a guy in any kind of pink color, makes me nervous.
For those of you who do not have color television, Charles is wearing pink trousers and a pink sweater.
Afghan.
May I add pink dirty trousers? Even I can see them with my eyes. They have spots all over.
I think we should all go to the nut house and surrender.
Listen. I think we ought to have a go at Match Game 74.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Let's meet our two players here, Dick Harper and Carol Malloy. Hello, Dick and Carol.
All right.
Dick is our current champ. This fella has won $6,900. How about that? Yes, sir. He's been winning game after game here. He's being challenged now by Carol, who matched two of our celebrities in her first round question. His first round question will come up in a moment or so, but first, we want you to pay strict attention to this. Here we go. Push this button and reveal our other first round question for you, Dick Harper. And here, this is it. Everybody plays.
Yes.
Marcus Welby's nurse said to the patient, "Don't drink from that water pitcher. Dr. Welby keeps his blank in it." Did you hear that, Dick? Marcus Welby's nurse said to the patient, "Don't drink from that water pitcher. Dr. Welby keeps his blank in it." Yes. Are you ready there?
There we go. Ready.
Oh, that was very quick there, group. Dick, you ready? Marcus Welby's nurse said to the patient, "Don't drink from that water pitcher. Dr. Welby keeps his blank in it."
Scalpel.
Scalpel. Some lady said right on when you said scalpel.
Right on baby, she said.
Right on baby. Okay, yeah. Scalpel.
There's a militant out there.
Yeah.
I have a very ugly cousin who works for a doctor, and she's not a nurse. She just stands in front of the office and makes people sick. He keeps his false teeth there.
False teeth. Yeah, that's a good one. Okay. Nice smile. Doesn't he have a nice smile? Yes, Brett, may we see yours?
Yes, did he say false teeth?
False teeth is what he said.
I said teeth.
Teeth. That seems to be the answer, Dick.
Sorry, Rick.
He says, "Don't drink from that water pitcher. Dr. Welby keeps his blank."
You know when the doctor gives you the little bottle?
Yeah.
I
wish I had one right now.
Come on. Dr. Welby, because I know personally,
I'll
he gives you a pitcher or a specimen.
Exactly. Did you put that on?
Okay.
See, I used to work in a doctor's office.
Yes.
Yes, and I took all the specimens as they came in.
All right. Okay.
Florence Nightingale strikes again.
Now swallow your tongue. I said teeth.
Teeth. All right. He said scalpel. That's what he's looking for. What have you got,
Joanne? I'm afraid I said teeth.
Teeth. Boy, you have done well with your 10 teeth. Yeah, but, you know, second guessing. Okay, Carol.
I'll take A, please.
A is what you want. Let's see, now, last time you matched Richard and Joanne, the two of you will not participate. Everybody else will.
We're ready.
When Tarzan married Jane, he didn't have a necktie, so he wore a blank around his neck.
When are you going to run away with me?
When Tarzan married Jane, he didn't have a necktie, so he wore a blank around his neck.
Lovely.
Gene, even though I can't play, I thought
yes.
I might.
Oh, that's neat. Okay. You got it.
I'll be seeing you in all,
right,
all the old familiar places.
Next. Hurry up, Tallulah. We're waiting. Okay.
Finish.
Now, Carol Malloy. When Tarzan married Jane, he didn't have a necktie, so he wore a blank around his neck.
All I can think of is like a tiger tail. A tiger tail, or a, you know, tail off an animal.
You got the message from the audience, Carol. I think they're trying to tell you something. Tiger tail is her answer.
Well, you see, Tarzan and Jane, we're not married. That's what Cheetah was laughing at when he's pointing at Boy.
Oh. Vine. Brett.
Has Vine,
yeah, very good answer.
Indeed.
Vine.
Oh, I said, not that you should turn on me like you've turned on Hero. I'm here every week. I said a monkey's tail.
Oh.
And you wanted to know how I finished.
That was close. All right,
that
Charles.
Was a tail, an
I'm back to the street I used to live on in Hartford, Vine Street.
Vine.
Exactly. Yeah, see?
Vine. Yes, ma'am.
I said a grapevine.
Grapevine. Okay, you got a lot of vines there.
Vine again.
All right, now, Dick, when we get back to you, you're going to have to score two matches to achieve a tie. Three, however, will win your umpteenth game. And that, we'll find out how that turns out right after we find out about this. Hello. Shall we go? All right,
yeah,
you ready?
Let's get out of here. Yes.
All right, now, it's two to tie, three to win. Here we go. Everybody plays. It was Thanksgiving. And Tom said to his wife, Fran, I don't think you cooked this turkey long enough. It's blanking.
Oh, I got it.
You got it.
Good gravy. Right, but what is it?
It was Thanksgiving, and Tom said to his wife, Fran, I don't think you cooked this turkey long enough. It's blanking. Fran.
Get your eyes away from my answer, Charles.
Oh, I don't know if I
want to
say that.
Yeah.
I don't know anything else.
Let me just, I didn't see what you had done there. And,
How's that one?
Okay, anything. It's up to you. Trust your own first instinct and you'll be all right.
Don't ask the teacher.
Slip it there. Okay, here we go. Dick Harper. It was Thanksgiving. Tom said to his wife, Fran, I don't think you cooked this turkey long enough. It's blanking.
It's moving.
It's moving. All right. He says it's moving, Nipsey. What do you say about that turkey?
Well, turkeys don't just move, they gobble.
Gobble. No. No. Okay, sorry, Brett.
I'm sorry I said gobble, 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 gobble.
Oh, yeah. That's the noise they make, isn't it, Charles?
Why turn on those two? I said gobbling.
Gobbling. Gobbling. Uh-oh.
When I've ever undercooked a bird, it bled. So
oh, dear.
That's the one I threw away.
Isn't this a strange turn of events? You got to match the two remaining ones to stay in the game. Richard.
Well, Dick and I have been through so much.
Yeah.
We won all that money for the vacation.
Right.
What else could I write? Moving.
Moving. There's one. If you match Joanne, you get a tie. Joanne, may we see it, please?
I don't even want to show it.
You don't?
I don't mind talking. I'm so ashamed
talking.
Of myself.
Carol Malloy wins the game. Come on down, Carol. Congratulations. Okay. Well, Dick, you've won four games. You've got $6,900, and I guess you're happy about that, right?
Yes, very happy.
You were terrific.
Thank you.
Great to meet you.
Thank you.
Good. So long, Dick Harper. Well, Carol, here we are. How do you feel?
Oh, I'm nervous. You knew from my last answer.
What's that?
You must know I'm nervous from my last answer.
What about your last answer?
Tiger's tail.
Oh, it was a rotten answer, wasn't it?
Yes, it really was.
But you won the game, though.
I know.
Yeah. You got the money.
Oh, I'm excited.
Good. All right. Now, you just calm down, okay. And we'll play the big money here. The super match is coming up. You know how this goes? We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Tiger Blank. Well, is this the coincidence of all time? Well, I don't know when that audience was here. What, 2 or 3 weeks ago or 4 weeks ago, whenever it was? And the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that top one. And then if you match the next one, it's $250. And the third, $100. Now, which celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Joanne.
I'm glad you said first. I don't know if they would say tiger's tail, so I'm going to say tiger's milk.
Tiger's milk. Okay, there's one.
Oh, maybe.
There. Getting a little booing on that one, but now you got to pick another one.
Charles, please.
Charles.
And she's looking at Richard.
I'm sorry.
She doesn't like you, Charles.
Wait a minute. Did you mean Richard?
Yes, I meant Richard.
You mean you were looking right at Richard and you said Charles?
Don't feel embarrassed. We often get mistaken. I have one for you.
What?
Tiger Lily.
Oh, yes.
Tiger Lily.
Oh, I have.
Don't sneer.
Okay, now you've got two.
Charles.
I'm Bruce.
You can swing that rag dog.
Yes, Bruce.
No, I have a wonderful friend named Tiger Haynes, but only I, you know, Tiger Haynes.
No, it's a little
but
too.
But anyway, after I plugged him, I'll say Tiger Rag.
Tiger Rag.
Tiger Rag, it's a song that was written before you were born, my dear. There's a hole that tiger, boom. Hole that tiger, boom. There's a thing that did. You old-timers remember that one, don't you?
No!
Come on. Okay, now which one of those do you want, or do you want to dream up one of your own?
No, Tiger Lily.
Tiger Lily. That's the one that Richard gave you. We'll find out if it's up there now. And if it's there, where is it? First, may we see the $100 response. Tiger in your tank. That's what you said, Nipsey?
Tiger, that's what
tiger
she
in
said
your tank.
Too.
Okay.
We said it together.
No Tiger Lily so far.
Tiger
Let's find
rag.
Out if it's under the $250 response. Tiger Rag.
Oh, rag also. Bruce. Right here, Bruce. Number one.
Terrific, Bruce. Knit me one of those pink sweaters, would you?
Okay.
Okay.
To match your pink shirt.
Right. Here we go. Last chance for Tiger Lily, the $500 response. Tiger Lily! Yay! Hello! Congratulations. Okay.
I didn't think it was
very good. Okay, you've got the $500. Now you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Remember to collect. You've got to match one celebrity. It's time to choose one.
Richard.
Now get the
best one. The guy with the blue jacket and the crazy.
I'm Rachel.
Yeah.
Steve.
Fly me to Denver.
All right, you get ready to write. You face me if you would, please. Here we go with the $5,000 question. $5,000. Watch blank. That's W-A-T-C-H blank. Watch blank.
Oh, it hurts like two
faces. Okay, Carol, he's finished. Now, we need an answer from you which you think will match his answer. What say you to this? Watch blank.
Pocket.
Watch pocket.
What?
Don't like that? No.
I like that answer.
Two people love it, the rest hate it. There. But it's your ball game, and we'll find out right now. Richard, she says, watch pocket. May we see your answer, please, for $5,000.
I'm sorry, my darling. I said watch band.
Watch band. Apparently the audience like watch band better than they like watch pocket, although I don't think watch pocket's such a bad answer, but watch band, I must admit, is a little bit better. Now, Carol, you're up to $600, and that ain't bad for 20 minutes work here, and you're going to play another game, and you may win some more. Who knows? Before we do that and meet another player, we've got to meet this commercial here. All right, we're ready to have a go at another game here. And we're very pleased to present another player. So let's welcome Rebecca Seitlin. How are you, Rebecca?
Fine.
You know Carol?
Yes, hi.
Where are you from?
Miami, Florida.
Miami, Florida?
Yes.
What else you want to tell us about Rebecca?
Well, I go to school at Gainesville, University of Florida, and I majored in speech pathology and audiology.
Archaeology.
Audiology.
Oh, audiology. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Listen.
Would she like to borrow my hearing aid?
How now, brown cow? This speech pathologist here, I can't understand what she's talking about. But anyway, I will understand her as we play this game. Are you ready to have a go at it?
Yes.
Okay, there's the button. Bing. Whoops, there we go. Now, we got A and B. Which one do you want?
A.
You want A. Everybody plays. New game, folks. Richard Dawson said...
Oh, he didn't.
I love a parade.
He said, last night... I have this terrible dream. I dream that Brett Summers was my blank. Okay.
Charles!
Charles, what are you doing, Charles?
You know you cannot keep him awake.
Oh, dear me.
I was just thinking what a nightmare that must have been.
Now, Rebecca, here it is. Richard Dawson said last night, I have this terrible dream. I dreamed that Brett Summers was my...
wife?
Wife. She said wife, Mitzi.
I dreamed I was eating spaghetti from the midnight till the dawn, and when I awoke this morning, my pajama string was gone.
Okay. One for you. What about this dream, Brett?
May I be excused to go to the blank? Never know. Well, I said wife.
Aww.
Actually, we're dating.
You are dating.
Mm-hmm.
Very quiet, isn't it? I mean, I haven't seen it in Rona Barrett's column.
We are dating.
You are dating.
I'm dating Carol.
Dating me.
And Charles? I'm dating Charles.
Yes, Charles.
She's a very sick woman. Wife.
Hello there, Anita.
Hello there, Gene.
What have you got written on that card?
Well, I know that Richard probably doesn't want to marry anybody, especially Brett.
Okay, so you said wife. You did very well with that one, Rebecca. It's unusual for a first-round question. And Richard, what say you to this dream?
It's an unusual question.
Yes, it was. You were there, weren't you?
Yes, and I enjoyed that dream.
You did?
Well, because I knew I'd wake up in the morning and I'd be single.
Wife. That's right.
I pronounce thee man and woman.
Okay.
Oh, well, who wouldn't say wife?
Wife! Well, look at that. Well, let me tell you, that doesn't happen too often. Six times there. Six celebrities matched in the first round. Let's see. Now, Carol, you got to match all six to stay in the running. You'll have two shots at it, and here we go. Everybody plays. George said... my neighbors are really strange. Not only do they steal my hubcaps, but they use them as blanks. George said.
Oh, what is that thing that you use?
Shh.
George
said.
Yeah.
My neighbors are really strange. Not only do they steal my hubcaps, but they use them as blanks. All right. Well, let me whisper to me what you're trying to think. Is that what you're trying
to think of?
All right.
All right. She thought of
okay.
It.
All right. We got to move along here, folks. Put them in the slots as soon as you're finished. All right. Everybody's finished, and we'll come over here to Carol Malloy. George said, my neighbors are really strange. Not only do they steal my hubcaps, but they use them as blanks.
Frisbees.
Frisbee. She said frisbee.
That's funny. That's what I was trying to think of.
You were trying to think of that, too. Brett, what did you say?
I hate to repeat myself, but my eyepiece be excused to go to the blank. I said frisbee!
Frisbee! Okay, Charles.
Frisbee!
Frisbee! Three frisbees. Why are you frowning?
Oh, because I have a weird sense of something. I thought they used them as dishes, you know?
As dishes? Well, those are weird neighbors. What did you say about these weirdos, Richard?
Frizzies is a great answer.
Yeah.
But see, these neighbors are really tough. You know what I mean? These hamburgers use them as cufflinks. Oh, so embarrassed.
I think you're weirder than the neighbors there. What about you, Joanne?
She says, Frisbee!
Hey, look at that. Okay. 4-6 is a score. Now we've got another round to go. At least you've got one more shot at it here. But before anything else happens, this has to happen for you, dear. A brief word from you, my dear, because we want to hear where you're playing.
Thank you. I'll be in Portland, Oregon, October 7th for 2 weeks in a nightclub called The Greenwood. Goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn from Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.